Good evening. The state television company Western Armenia represents the most important events of these days. Today's broadcast. Armenak Abrahamyan awards Vahan Badasyan with the Republic of Western Armenia's World Medal. Conference held on the Artsakh issue today. France threatens European Union sanctions against Turkey if they violate the terms of ceasefire in Artsakh. The announcement of the cessation of hostilities will lead to full negotiations, Zakharova. Tombs of the Roman period in the heart of Tigranakert. ECM has released the new City of Tigran Mansuryan's works. President of the Republic of Western Armenia, Armenak Abrahamyan, awarded Member of Parliament of the Republic of Western Armenia, Knight of the Battle Cross, leader of the United Armenia Party of Artsakh, Vahan Badasyan, with a sword medal. Badasyan has been on the front line since the first day of the war unleashed by Azerbaijan and Turkey. Then, after receiving a head injury, he was transferred to Armenia. At the moment, Mr. Badasyan is still in the hospital receiving appropriate rehabilitation treatment. On November 7, a conference entitled The Artsakh Issue Today took place. The Prime Minister of the Republic of Western Armenia, Sedat Melikian, made an opening speech at the conference. Then President Armenak Abrahamyan presented the topic of the conference in more detail. During the conference, Armenak Abrahamyan presented what is the current status of Artsakh from the legal point of view and what steps should be taken. Noted that now the situation is quite difficult and everything must be done to save the homeland and the people. Mr. Abrahamyan showed and presented the situation on the map, noting that if everything is focused only on Artsakh, it will not be possible to solve the common Armenian issue, taking into account that in this case a number of important rights of Armenians have been violated, which are easily exercised for Turks and jihadists. The aim of this program is to continue the genocide perpetrated against Armenians of Western Armenia. At the moment, it is more important to take steps toward the international community by presenting them with the general legal package of the Armenian issue. Concluding his speech, he added that we have a history and honor to fight and to resist. Turkey must accept the terms of the ceasefire concluded by the parties to the Artsakh conflict, otherwise the European Union may impose additional sanctions against the country. French Foreign Minister Jean-Yves Le Drian said in a meeting of the National Assembly of France, TASS reports, regarding the agreement that was concluded after the events of this night and which we did not have time to comment on the day before, we consider it important that Turkey absolutely strictly adhere to the agreed ceasefire, because otherwise it risks facing increased sanctions. The French Foreign Minister said in response to a question about Turkey's influence on the events in Nagorno-Karabakh. The minister specified that in December the European Union countries will hold another summit at which, among other things, Turkey's aggressive behavior will be discussed. Earlier, 27 countries of the community have already decided that if Turkey does not change its behavior, measures will be taken against it, including sanctions, that options are already on the table, he stressed. Russian Foreign Ministry spokesperson Maria Zakharova has said that the Russian-mediated Artsakh Republic armistice signed between Armenia and Azerbaijan will lead to a full negotiations process over the conflict. The statement expects an unconditional transition to full-fledged negotiation process on all aspects of this, unfortunately complex and difficult problem, TASS quoted Zakharova. The Artsakh armistice was signed by Prime Minister of the Republic of Armenia Nikol Pashinyan, the President of the Republic of Azerbaijan Aliyev, and the President of the Russian Federation Putin on November 10. Excavations continue in the Amida Hill of Tigranakert, Western Armenia, where the Huri, Mitanni and other Urartian civilizations lived. Excavations have uncovered 1,700-year-old Roman tombs. In addition, canals and heating systems have been discovered, which are estimated to be 1,800 years old. The tomb where the stone sarcophagus was found dates back to Roman times, and probably the ruling elite was buried in the cemetery under the palace. So far, graves have been found in 7 places, where human bones and skeletons are found. The famous ECM recording studio in Munich has recently released Tigran Mansuryan's Con Anima album, which includes 6 works by the beloved composer. In a conversation with Armen Press correspondent, the composer said that the album summarizes the chamber works created in recent years. Music traditions have a strong direction in these recordings, Mansuryan said. The album was addressed by famous music critic Norman Labrie, who believes that in these tense and difficult times, Con Anima can become the best way to spend the next 15 minutes of life. Mansuryan's language is Armenian, but his music is marked by the references of minimalism, atonalism, and microtonic system, Lebrich said, noting that ECM has referred to Tigran Mansuryan's works for years. Let's hope that Mansuryan will be able to continue composing in peace, the music critic concluded. Now let us represent to your attention a song, Vark Hayot. can find the whole version of the song in the official page of Western Armenia TV. This was all for today. Goodbye.